Hello friends, I am Sushant Raghavan. Welcome to technical and quality session. For understanding the technical requirements and quality standards in clothing industry, making a sustainable garment, I have good practical experience in the apparel manufacturing sector. My skills are CAD pattern making, sample development, technical requirements, and measuring quality performance. Today's session is about implementation of standardization in the apparel industry. For more sessions like this, do like and subscribe to my channel. Now let's begin the presentation. Implementation of standardization. The natural progression of Kaizen is standardization. What is standardization? Through Kaizen, we reach certain level of specialization in each attempt. When we see we have reached a certain level of mastery over a process or work method, it is important to analyze it and standardize the procedure so everybody in the workplace or throughout the company could follow the same steps without having to go through trial and error or using past methods. The most effective method to implement standardization to a company is by creating a standard operating procedure, which we call SOP. This is the most common and easiest method to develop, document, and use standardization. Let's look at how we develop a SOP. First step is to identify the process, line, or the floor we are planning to implement standardization. Create a flow chart explaining in detail each step of the operation and how it should be done. Take photographs, mockups, and other relevant items such as trims and use them as visual samples where necessary. Ensure relevant manager check and sign each SOP to avoid mistake and future disputes. Components of standardized work. There are three main components in properly achieving standardized work. Ticket time. Ticket time is how many pieces needed to be done in order to meet the demand or delivery in the case of apparel industry. Ticket time need to be calculated for each operation, so where needed, we could balance the line with coupling work or putting additional workstations. Work sequence. Work sequence highlights the importance of having a smooth layout. It is important to work out the number of machines, what type of machines, and how many operators and helpers need to carry out the task. Standard in process. Materials discuss the work in progress, which we know as WIP. It is important to have the right amount of work available to perform the operation. Components of standardized work. Let's say line A producing printed round neck t-shirts. When planning production, manager has to ensure print panels are available on time to run the line. For an example, if the daily target is 500 pieces, then printing plan needs to ensure they deliver daily requirement ahead of the time. Otherwise, line idling is a result and overtime to cover it up or ended up in missing the deadlines. Sounds simple, and most of you will be thinking, of course, you have to plan embellishments and other trims before the input. But how many times we have missed production targets due to mistakes in planning? This is where standardization and other lean tools come in handy. One system in place, it is highly unlikely recurrence of simple but costly mistakes, because everybody in the organization is trained to think strategically and continuous improvement are in the mind of everybody. Components of standardized work. There are tremendous benefits by having standardization as a part of the way of work in any organization. The most important benefit is the consistency. If we take apparel industry as an example, we all know how important each piece coming out of the machine has to be. Having the right quality and the right measurements are paramount. Imagine a situation where collars are too long or too narrow for the body, and nightmare situation most of us faced in the production lines. Some garments are puckering, some garments measurement out, and eventually creating a huge headache for all involved. Through the standardization, easily these mistakes can be avoided. Components of standardized work. As a part of SOP, line supervisor could have a mock-up collar on the machine, have a size pack attached to the machine table, so after sewing each piece, operator could quickly check the length to ensure measurements are correct. Also, diagram showing how to keep the parts of the collar and fusing on the table, visually explaining the sight and direction is necessary so that operators don't make mistakes and waste time trying to figure out how to arrange the pieces from the bundles. As we know, people get absence without prior notice, people get replaced, so chances are new person joining the production line is constant. If the company uses standardization as a tool, the time taken to train a new employee reduced by almost 30%. They become more productive employees and produce less damages. Components of standardized work. Other benefits include reliability, increased throughput and efficiency. As we discussed above, standardization help to reduce rework, saving time and money, and more importantly, helping to meet the planned deadlines. Another great advantage of standardization is every tool, machine and equipment has a place of its own, so people can find them easily. So no time wasted looking for an item when needed. Further, having a culture where everybody embraces doing things right, placing things in the correct place where they belong, and give attention to detail, improve the workplace atmosphere and the relations between employees and managers, as nobody is in distress. Components of standardized work. It is very important to note that standardized methods are only valid until Kaizen finds another improved method. Once you have a better method, processes or system, it is important to change the previous SOP and replace with the new improved SOP. Most cases, we have old SOPs hanging on the machines and workstations. These are the companies who follow Lean just to make buyers happy and have no idea what these Lean tools represent. Thank you for watching. For more sessions like this, do like and subscribe to my channel. Please comment your valuable thoughts. And don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified when I post a new presentation. Bye, have a good day.